What up, everybody? Welcome back to Fro Publications YouTube channel. It's always me, Rich, and today I got some zines coming out of a company called Phone Book Publishing, a company in New York. So let's go ahead and get into it. Bam! This is the zine that I'm talking about. It's called Call and Response. This is issue number 7, the February issue, and it was sent to me by Brian Flattery, who is the founder and editor-in-chief of Phone Book Publishing. So I'm very appreciative for this zine. Thank you so much, Brian, for sending this out to me. What do I want to say about this? Well, to begin with, the idea, the premise is amazing. Let me go ahead and tell you what it is. Give me 1 second. It reads, Call and Response is a collaborative magazine which pairs artists of various media in order to create unique artistic conversations. It goes like this. Contributors each submit an original work in their preferred media. This is the call. Next, those submissions are shuffled up and sent back out to the contributors at random. Finally, each contributor creates a new piece inspired by or in conversation with the call they received. This is the response. It is our hope that this exercise will spark new ideas, challenge the participants, and cultivate creative partnerships that will continue beyond this magazine. Amazing idea. Very well executed. The print quality on this is amazing. It just feels amazing, looks amazing. The internals are really good. There's a lot of things that I like about this zine. One of the things is that there is a very, very strong presence of working class humor, working class ideology. So one of the pieces that I liked a lot was a global warming comic. And that was by Colby Smith, who did the call, and then Zach DiLanzo, who did the response. I really liked that one a lot. Another one that I enjoyed a lot was another one that was called Upper Middle Class. But yeah, there's so much undertones of just like working class humor, ideology, and at that, like, it's kind of artist specific. There's a piece in there, I forget what it was, but it was this piece about bands selling out and like how people like the band when they're starving artists and they're unable to pay their bills and all this shit, but the minute that they're able to sustain their livelihood through their art, they sold out. And I thought that was a very interesting piece as well. Luckily in this issue, another thing is that they mentioned is that there's a moment of transition for Call and Response. And it was in this issue that they started something called the Artist Spotlight. And this issue, they start talking to a fellow by the name of Austin Antoine. And he's a hip hop artist. And they go into this in-depth investigative journalist attitude that really is journalism, but for artists. And so they start talking about the moves and maneuvers that he's been doing as a hip hop artist to grow. And they talk about certain things like his 16-hour freestyle cipher that is in the Guinness World Records. They talk about his ideas about scaling. They talk about ultimately, you know, just a multitude of different things that pertain to artists, artist specific. And so I really, really enjoyed that. And the last piece that I enjoyed a lot was there's a call and then there's like 5 responses and it's all from the same artist who just was trying to figure it out. And I enjoyed seeing that as well. I think Brian did a really, really great job in including each one of those to show kind of how the artist's minds work and how we think and overthink and do and redo. And so I thought that was very, very clever, man. I really, really enjoyed this zine. I really think Phone Book Publishing is doing a great job. I really think that Call and Response is an amazing zine. And so if you guys have you know, that time and space to check them out, check out the website. I know they have samples of the zines. If you guys got the dough to spend, go ahead and get one of these, man. These are fucking amazingly done. But all right, guys, until next time.
Fight the fashion.
And late.